Good morning to all of you. I am sure that you all have been enjoying, though a couple of you have been running noses, and I heard that some of you fell down. A nice place to fall down and a nice place to have your nose running. Okay. Yeah, news has been coming to me from as far as USA, saying that some of our children fell down and some of them have running nose. I told your parents that, well, allow them 3 days and they would be standing up and running in their Christian life. You would forget all about running noses. Great spending time with all of you. I'm sure that all of you enjoyed the classes yesterday. Some of the CND group students, they missed my class that I had in the afternoon, but what I mentioned or what I taught yesterday afternoon is of vital importance to you, and many of those subjects have been loaded in the form of e-books on my websites. So if any one of you is already there on the net, and if you are not linked to me, that's a big loss. Loss for me, I mean, that you are not linked to me. So please do get linked to me, okay? SBS publishes a PDF bulletin. It is known as SBS Today. And all of you who gave your email address to us would be getting SBS Today from the next issue onwards, and the next issue would have a report of this camp. If any one of you could not give your email address to me, please make it sure that you give your email address to me. There is one more thing I want to bring to your attention. SBS would like to report about its activities to as wide an audience as possible, and therefore, if you have friends, cousins, members of your church, we are looking only for people from assembly background, and if you can give their email addresses to me, please help SBS by giving their email addresses to me. If there is anyone here who is adventurous enough to give me 10 to 20 email addresses, I, to express my thanks, will give you a compliment. This is purely to express my thanks. This is the complete Bible printed in Netherlands. We will give you a complimentary copy of this Bible to express our thanks if you help us to build up our mailing list. Our aim is to get SBS Today to as wide an audience worldwide as possible. So if you help us, we are thankful to you, and we would express it very practically. Okay? So I have a couple of copies yesterday, and to my surprise, though I gave this offer to the younger ones, it's an auntie who claimed it for yesterday. She gave me about 25 email addresses and claimed the first complimentary Bible. Anyway, I have a couple more left. Don't forget. We have been reading from the scripture, studying from the scripture, and our key verse is 2 Timothy 2, verses 16 and 17. All scripture is inspired by God and is profitable for doctrine, reproof, correction, instruction in righteousness. Did I make a mistake? 2 Timothy. Oh, thank you for the correction. Do you know what you ought to understand from that? You're not always going to remain young. You're going to grow old, and you're going to make mistakes. So do whatever you can do for the Lord while you have strength and while you have memory. A day will come when your memory will start failing. That has already started happening with me. Good. That's a good reminder that we need to do everything as much as possible, and we have to make maximum contributions in our spiritual life while we are young, while we are full of energy. There is a young guy, he is looking for someone. എന്ത് വേണം മോനെ യെസ് ഓക്കെ Now the verse says all scripture is inspired by God and it is profitable for doctrine and yesterday I reminded you that the word translated or words translated doctrine have been used hundreds of times in New Testament showing how important doctrine is. Doctrine is not something exotic or some theoretical idea. All biblical truths, all scriptural truths is God's truths. And one of the words to indicate scriptural truth or biblical truth is doctrine. So all biblical truth is inspired by God. It is necessary for us to give sufficient attention. We should never fight against it. And we should also never fight against those people who bring scriptures to us because God has appointed them to obtain illumination and share it with you and me. Okay, and then the scripture says that all scripture is profitable not only for doctrine but it is also profitable for reproof and correction. What exactly is reproof and correction? We all need to review things that we are doing. And the best example or illustration that I can give for that is the rear view mirror. What's the purpose of the rear view mirror in cars or even on two wheelers? Now they have rear view mirrors. The driver needs to continually evaluate his surroundings so that he is able to drive safely. So correction, all walk and all running in life needs continuous feedback and evaluation. Now when feedback comes to us and if we fail to heed to that feedback, then a person in position of authority speaks to us and that little speech is known as reproof and correction. It may come in many forms. Mom may say, Sonny, do your homework. Otherwise, this evening, you are going to miss your favorite TV program. It comes in a very gentle manner. Dad says, hey, little guy, you want to go for picnic this weekend, isn't it? Yes, Dad. Fine. I am very happy about that. Did you give your name to your teacher? No, Dad. Okay. Tomorrow you go, give your name to teacher, tell her that you would also be joining your class fellows for the picnic and also do tell her that if you don't complete your homework by that time, then you would fail to join. Some dads and moms put it in a very subtle manner. Some are more straightforward, but all of this is part of reproof and correction. The scripture repeatedly reminds that each believer in Christ should continually, regularly examine his or her own life. Since this is C&D group, I presume that all of you are born again. If there is anyone here who has not experienced what is known as the born again experience, then please come and talk to me. Talk to one of these uncles. Talk to one of these aunties. They would be very happy to explain what this born again experience or what salvation means. They are here not only to listen to the word of God, but also to help you, to counsel you. They would be very happy to explain the meaning of salvation and lead you to the experience of salvation. So if there is anyone here who has not accepted Lord Jesus yet, please make sure that you talk to one of these uncles or aunties or to me or one of the leaders today itself. Don't delay. If you are already born again, then you are a child of God, you are a believer, and it is your responsibility. It's vital that you examine yourself every day. 1 Corinthians chapter 11 verses 28 to 32. 1 Corinthians chapter 11 verses 28 to 32. But let a man examine himself. Now these verses are related to self-examination before a person participates in the Lord's table. And I'm sure that many of you participate in the Lord's table. But the principle that's mentioned here is applicable even to those who are not baptized yet. Let a believer in Christ examine himself and herself. Check whether you have been faithful to the Lord in your speech, in your thought life, in your actions. And I say this with great burden to children in this generation, because technological developments that have taken place in the last 10 years have changed everything upside down. I'm sure you have heard the term disruptive technologies, isn't it? Internet is a disruptive technology. Facebook is a disruptive technology. It disrupts. It turns upside down all the principles, all the protocols, all the things that we held dear to us. It also fights against our culture, a lot of things. And therefore, you live in very difficult times, my young friends. And it's vital that a young Christian examine himself or herself each day. How did I spend the day? Was I careless in my talk? Did I entertain lustful thoughts? Did I do something that is not suitable for a child of God? That's what the